Yeah, actually not joining, but I'm just supplying some lines.
It kind of takes some explanation of this, though. Basically, I've had a couple people take Dr. Weir's 101 rhetoric and 102 rhetoric class, and they all had subpar experiences. So we decided to put all of them together into one poem. What Dr. Weir says in the poem, she's literally said in class, and these experiences have gone in class, so it gives you an idea of what she goes through.
Just a caveat, I see some of my rhetoric 101 students here, and your classes are not like this.
Not yet. All right, an ode to Dr. Weir's rhetoric class. The crack of dawn finds foreheads on desks.
Good morning, humans.
Dr. Weir will profess, as the roll call starts with,
God bless you, Tim.
The doodles on paper and touch screens begin.
Oh, Katie, please, please get off of your phone.
Dr. Weir loses to button-click tones.
Oh, dear, it seems we've lost the back row.
Snores echo gently in their rooms below.
Did anyone read the passage I assigned?
Stares mixed with panic for all that she finds.
Well, let's get started. Turn to page 48.
20 students leave on a bathroom break. This all in a day, though the work of a year on Dr. Weir's sanity in her career. Weeks pass by slowly, quizzes forecast, and red F's stay common as Z's in the class.
This paper is due on the 4th of November.
Can I get an extension? Cries every last member. They plead ignorance, and they beg Dr. Weir.
Well, I don't know. You've had half a year.
The final comes up as attendance comes down. Week one paper's still rolling it down. Dr. Weir's warnings go unheeded past.
Study hard now. You can still pass.
Final grades post, and emails fly quickly. Oh, Dr. Weir, give me a break, please.
Well, I would if I could, my dear Mr. Lin, but this entire semester you've handed nothing.